Okay, thank you guys for coming to watch our presentation. So today we're going to talk about promoting and maintaining ADLs with individuals that have dementia.
And this is Kara, and I'm Amber, and we are OTA students.
Okay, so the first,
and we handed you guys a questionnaire beforehand, and all the questions that you had filled out, we're going to answer in PowerPoint.
Perfect. Okay, so before we get started, does anyone know what dementia is?
Yes.
Well, okay. I know the facts. I don't know the
definition. What do you think it is?
Memory loss.
Yes, so that's what it is. So dementia describes those symptoms that happen. There are different types of dementia. 6 to 8% of those that do have dementia are classified as Alzheimer's or AD is what we'll use throughout the presentation. Now there's symptoms such as memory loss, cognitive difficulties, visual impairments, just different progressions. Now dementia, looking at Alzheimer's, will have 4 stages. So throughout the presentation, we'll be describing different tools that you can use to help an individual throughout all 4 stages. But to just sum up the stages, stage 1, that's when they start noticing memory loss. Stage 2, the memory loss gets severe, and then there's cognitive difficulties as well. And then you have stage 3 and 4, where usually an individual needs full-time care. They're unable to go to the restroom on their own. They're unable to walk, just different things. Now, the second part of our presentations are ADLs. So ADLs are activities that we do every day for self-care. So such as bathing, eating, things like that, that we will discuss throughout the presentation for each slide.
What is ADLs?
Activities of daily living.
Okay.
Good question.
So like the things that you would do in your daily routine, like when you're getting dressed and like putting bathroom hygiene and stuff.
Okay, and then a caregiver. Does anyone know what a caregiver is? Mm-hmm. Go ahead and state what you think.
Okay. Somebody who provides that care for the person who can't do it themselves. So getting them in dressed.
Exactly. So there are 2 types of caregivers. There's those that are family members, and then individuals that you pay to come into your home to help take care of your family. So the focus of our presentation will be mostly on family members that are taking care of their family member that has dementia at home. So one of the ADLs that a lot of individuals will have difficulty with is dressing. You might think, why would a person have trouble with dressing? Once you learn dressing at age 3 or 4, you know how to dress yourself. But with an individual that has Alzheimer's, they have difficulty sequencing the steps of dressing. So they will remember to put on one pants leg, but then forget what they're doing and not put on the next pants leg. So one way that you can help your family members to provide what we call verbal cues. So just remind them of the steps and make sure that you don't give them more than 1 or 2 steps to do at a time. So you can say, go ahead and put one leg in, and then have them do it. Okay, next, put your other leg in. Now stand up, pull your pants up, and then zip or buckle your pants. And just make sure it's slow. At times, some caregivers are in a rush and they get frustrated. And then once you become frustrated, that makes it difficult for the individual to understand what you are saying as well. And then there's different aids that you can use. So if they have trouble zippering their pants, we have what we call an OT as a zipper pull. So you'll teach them to hook on the zipper and then pull it straight up. That makes it much easier because there is a decrease in fine motor skills. And when zipping up your pants, you do need the fine motor skills.
And then also, another thing for dressing, you can also label the dresser and make sure they know where everything is. And that would increase their independence.
Okay, and then we have bathing, and Amber's going to talk to you about bathing. Go
go over a meeting, they're assuming the same thing, they're gonna have problems with sequencing. So just laying out, like having a shadow bench or even having just like the mommy-o-lo brush is gonna help them like remembering, hey, I need a baby today, or it's also gonna tell them exactly, you know, what they need. You can even number it if you want to. And then there's also stuff for like for grab bars and handles also. They should be in the shower for fall prevention as well.
And then you can also use mats outside. So a lot of people, I know when I got hurt, the scariest part was actually stepping out of the tub and making sure you don't slip. So you can put a non-slip mat there for your family member as well, so that they know how to just step out. That helps increase their confidence in stepping out of the tub, and then making sure the towel is within reach to help with that sequence. So they know I step out, then I look to the right, or I look straight forward, and there's my towel. That's the next step of bathing. And then another area of an ADL is feeding. Now, with feeding, there are different tools that you can use. Bright colored plates can help the individual. And then also cutting up the foods. So you want to prevent choking hazards for your family member. When they get into stage 3 or 4, they forget how to use a fork, so you'll see them stabbing down. So make sure that the food is bite-sized, because if it's too big, they'll still stab down, but because of the decrease in their vision, they're not going to see that, oh, this is a big piece, before they try to place it in their mouth. There's also with drinking, we have cups that have 2 handles to help, so they'll hold and then they'll drink, or we have nose cups where it will limit the motion that they have to use with their neck. So you just bring it up and you'll be able to drink without having to bend backwards as well. And then of course there are behavioral difficulties that come with Alzheimer's, and then there's just a couple steps to help remain calm and be patient. Don't internalize what they're saying, because they don't know what they're saying at times.
And if you repeat, you have to repeat, which is
so that's a major thing. And then with being a caregiver, stress management. So if you find yourself becoming stressed, take that time to calm down. If it means taking 5 minutes to breathe, to step away from the situation, that will help not only yourself, but the individual that you're caring for.
And then there's also...
And lastly, there are environmental modifications. So Amber had mentioned one earlier where you can just put labels on their dressing, their dresser, so they know, okay, the top will be pants, then the second will be shirts, and then socks, just to help with the labeling. Also decluttering the home to prevent fall risks, and taking out the rugs, just so they don't trip over the rugs, different things like that that you wouldn't think about.
Labeling the exits and entrances, and you know, doors that you don't want them to go to, actually, sometimes they will listen if you put stop on.
And then remove flammable things that are in the house. Make sure that it's not in reach for that individual. Sometimes they'll just see something that's bright and not realize that bright red means don't touch that. So it's a great idea if you have a cabinet to just lock it with all your flammable and sharp objects as well. And there are just some resources on this slide that will go ahead and give you more information about feeding and eating and even driving for an individual that is older.
And we've also provided you with a tip sheet with pretty much everything that we talked about. And we'll give you the activity suggestions and strategies to use that are OTU.